Hey guys and girls, welcome to a brand new series I'm going to be doing in Farming Simulator 19, and this is episode number one, and we are going to be calling this series Cows Are Cool. What we're going to be doing in this series is we're starting with $10 million. Yes, I know, it's a small amount of money when you're trying to set up a dairy farm. And that's what we've gone and done over here. We've got ourselves a bit of equipment at the moment. We've got ourselves a Scania hook lift with the Bergman trailer on the back. We've got ourselves a Fendt harvester happening over here. And what we're going to be doing... Oh, I love this camera. This camera is so cool. It's the backup camera. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be running a dairy farm. Now, I haven't bought the cattle yet. So I wanted to bring you guys in and just show you... very quickly what's going on. So this is Felsbrunn, which is the map I kind of tend to like playing on because the location of the shop and basically everything in general is pretty cool. Now this is where our cow farm is. It's located right next to our main farm here, and what we've done is we've bought the large cow facility, which can hold up to 200 cows, as you can see here. Got to do quite a bit of terrain editing to get it to fit. But should be good. Should be good. So we're going to get about 200 cows into this farm. And we are going to treat these cows like they are royalty. So they're going to have the best food, the best care. If that means I have to buy all the hay and all the product just to get us going, then that's what we'll be doing. Because we want these cows to be profitable and well looked after. So, this is our main farmyard. Now, I haven't bought any tractors yet. No tractors, no farming implements yet. So, I thought I would bring you guys in and just to let you know what's going on. So, I have a small silage bunker right here, right next to the main part of the farm. I also have a hayloft. Now, I've got no idea what a hayloft does. No idea in the world. But I got one. Because I figured if it's got hay, then it has to do with cows, so we have one. No idea what it does or what the purpose for it is. I suppose that's something I'm going to learn as we go along. Got a ladder over here. Not sure why. Can we even climb that ladder? Is that possible? Oh my goodness, we can climb the ladder. That is so cool. So as I said, we're going to be starting off with $10 million. Now, I'm just harvesting this paddock here to get a bit of wheat in. Because what I intend on doing is I intend on basically growing produce that's going to produce the bales that we need to keep our cows happy. Now, at the moment, I've disabled the straw swath just for the first run because I wanted to make sure that the harvester we got was actually going to be decent. As I said, I'm not going to go with the ultimate maximum equipment on this farm, you know, like there's no point getting an 80-foot header for a paddock this small. but as you can understand, we are going to be doing things. Oh, a little bit of a frame drop there. As you can understand, this is brand new farm setup for me. And I'm just going to bring you guys along for the journey. Much like my Minecraft My Way series, this will be Farming Simulator 19 My Way. Now, I might do things completely wrong. I might, you know, do things properly. I might completely mess things up. But anyway, I thought I would bring you guys along and just show you what this new series is going to be about. We're going to be getting, as I said, about 200 head of cattle. And we're going to try and make these cows as profitable as possible. I don't know quite the recipe for power food yet, but we'll get there. You know, this is where our milk will be stored once it finally gets all produced. It'll be here. This, I assume, is where we either water or feed the cows. This will be where we can pick the cows up. I'm going to assume this is the water one. Yeah, yeah. So that's something we'll have to take care of very quickly. Is we'll have to get some water on board for the animals. And we'll have to get some grass and all that kind of fun stuff. Yeah, that's pretty much where I'm at this point in time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically just buy another hook lift trailer for the water. So let's go in and purchase that now. So let's see, where would that be under? Under slurry tanks, maybe? No, not there. What about under animals? Let's check animals. We've got a Joskin trailer there. Okay, so it's not there. Wouldn't be under animal transport, would it? No. Slurry tanks, where else would it be? Would it be under trailers? Surely it wouldn't be under trailers. It is. Hook lift liquid container. Let's grab that. Now, my color, basically, whenever I play on a multiplayer server, is always purple. That's just my default coloring. Everything is purple. Don't ask questions. It's just what it is. So we're going to buy that. Yep. Okay. So what we'll do now is we will jump into this game now. After we deposit this container... Okay. Now I've got to make sure I drop it in a place where the combine's not going to get affected by it. Drop off. Now this is a Scania 6x4 with a rear steer axle, just making things easy to maneuver. And I should be able to attach. Good. Fold that up and let's go pick up that liquid container, and then we're going to go fill that up with water, so we're going to have at least water for the cows. As you can see, I started doing straw swath and then disabled it because I wasn't exactly sure what I was going to do, whether I'm going to initially buy the product first, like buy the hay bales first, or what. I don't know. So I decided to disable the straw swath because I haven't got any of the baling equipment or anything like that. Right, 1 second, let's just pull off the side of the road in case we get in trouble with the law for blocking the road. Okay, we're going to drive this guy up, so let's dismiss the worker and drive up to the container. Love the disco lights on this vent, the harvester, it's pretty cool. And drop that in. Now, for those of you who don't know, I run a AMD RX 570 8GB graphics card, and I've got MSI Afterburner engaged at the moment to bump the overclock up from 1240 something megahertz to 1263. So it's a little bit overclocked, not much. But as you can see, or you can't see, because I'm not sure if it will turn up in the game capture, I'm running at 60 frames at the moment, and we're only using 2.3 gigabyte of the 8 gig that we've got available. So I'm not sure if that's going to appear on the game capture or not, but just letting you know. So yeah, it's an MSI Armor 8 gigabyte OC overclock. I can disable the disco lights now, because I know he's full, because we just emptied it. So yeah, as I said, I wasn't exactly sure if I was going to, make my own bales or just buy them. I wasn't sure. And I think for the first couple of rounds, we might buy the bales first and use them. And then go from there, really. So as I said, it's not really going to be a realism-based series. It'll be, you know, if I start running low on money, I'm going to give myself some more. So really, the financial side of things is not something you guys need to worry about. I really should have left that silver, huh? Anyway. Doesn't quite match my truck. It's kind of like a... kind of like a... chameleon color. It goes from dark blue to pink. Oh well. Here's what it is. So we're gonna go fill this up for free. And I'll show you how to do that. Now this is a 50,000 litre container, so I've got to be real careful about how I do this. Because if I'm not careful, I will drop this entire truck into the dam and we will be in a world of pain. I should have an option to refill the trailer. And if this all goes to plan, then I should be able to haul it out without too much trouble. Now I don't need 50,000 litres of water just yet, but I'm better off filling this up now than worrying about it later on. Is it 50,000 or 20,000? I can't remember. Or is it 30,000? 30,000 liters? Is that what it is? Okay, so it's 30,000 liters, not 50,000. Oh, that's good enough. 28,000 liters, okay. Oh boy, this is going wrong. Power! Saved it. Just. Now it weighs a lot. Now, I'm not sure where the water fill-up point is just yet. I think it should be this one. But it won't let me refill it until we get the cows. So let's get the cows. Open dialogue. Now, this could be a very big mistake. Gonna get one of at least every kind to begin with. You know what? Let's double up on that. Okay. Black and white, so I need another brown. I think that should do us. Let's confirm that delivery. There we go. Now, the thing is, this only shows a limited amount of cows. It doesn't actually show you the lot. So you can have 200 cows in this space and it'll only generate like 50 of them, tops. So let's do some refilling. Wow, okay, that took 1,680 litres of water. Okay, we'll drive a bit further forward. And we're going to detach. And we nearly tipped the truck over. That's cool. Hey, Zeus, you missed a bit. Jeez, that's hard to find good help these days. Yeah,
Jesus, you missed a bit.
All right, let's get that pipe out. Righto. Our next step, guys and girls, is we are going to get ourselves a tractor. We're going to get ourselves a mower, and we're going to get some grass in, and so we can start generating some silage, and of course get some feed to those cows quick smart. All right, so let's go to the store and let's buy ourselves a tractor. That's a truck. I want a tractor. Now, do I want to go all out and go big? Or do I want to buy an actual mower? I think I'm going to buy a mower. I think we're just going to buy a mower straight out. Do they have mowers? Mowers. Okay, maybe not. Maybe we'll do this the old-fashioned way, huh? Ooh, let's go into miscellaneous and see what we got there. Misc. See? Misc. We've got a whole heap of stuff here. We've got lights if we need them. We've got the bag handler and... Okay, that tanker transports liquids too. That's kind of cool. Righto. Well, let's see. Harvesters? Mowers. Here we go. Mowers. That one's kind of cool. I like the look of that one. It's kind of weird, but let's see. I've got all these John Deere mowers here. Mower cuts grass. Why don't we just get that one? Why not? I'm going to lease it. Not going to buy it. I'm going to lease it. Lease. Yes. Okay. Let's go and get it. Wow, this thing's huge. Then we're going to have to buy ourselves a tractor. With a... Ooh, I don't know. What do you call them things? A forage wagon? Is that what it is? Yeah, we'll get a forage wagon up. And then we'll do that. Oh, massive frame lag there. Went down to 15 frames. RAM's gone up to about 2.4 gigabytes of video memory. So it hasn't used anywhere near the 8 gigabyte of RAM that it's got available. So that's kind of cool. Alright. Let's go down in here. Let's unfold the mower. Wide spreading mode. Toggle cruise. How do I change the toggle work mode? There it is. Swath dropping, left swath, right swath, wide spreading, swath dropping. I think that's what we want. Let's turn her on. Ooh, hydraulics. Back her up. Let's lower the mower. Let's see what we do. Now we're going to harvest all the grasses around near our farm first. Ooh, she's quick. Is it dropping it? Yeah, it is, right behind us. Cool, so I won't need to windrow it. be enough. So let's turn the mower off. Lift the mower up. Let's fold it. Let's go get ourselves a tractor and a forage wagon so we can pick it all up. So I'm going to go around the corner here. Whoop. A little sharp on the steering there. Park it right next to our harvester. Beauty. Righto, let's go purchase our tractor. Now, I think I'm going to go with my personal favorite. You guys all know what my personal favorite tractor is. Come on, if you haven't figured it out by now, you haven't been watching my series then. We're definitely going to be buying that. We're going to be leaving it as is. I think I'm going to up it to the 5,000 with a chip. So we've got plenty of horsepower on board. I'm going to change the color of the rims to red because that's what I like. Ooh, chrome. Red chrome? No. Where is it? There we go. Red class rims. Twin wheels, not too big. Wheels with weights, that's fine. Let's go the Goodyears, actually. The Goodyears are nice and big. I don't like the look of them, though. I like that look better. So let's go wheel weights. White tires and wheel weights. Beauty. That's what we want. We're going to buy that one. Yep. Okay. Now we're going to buy our forage wagon. Forage wagon, where are you? Where are you? Forage wagon. I bet you guys are going, dude, it's on the next screen. I'd be like, yeah, you're probably right. Loading wagons, that's what they're called. Let's go for... Ooh, what's the capacity of that one? 43,000? 56,000? I don't think we need something that big. 23,000, 34, 42. Let's go that one. Let's see what tires we can get. Michelin's. Let's go with wides, and we'll buy that one. I like the look of it too. All right, so let's get our tractor. And let's hook her up. Now, the reason why I love this thing so much is you can do all-wheel steering, you can do front steering, you can crab steer the damn thing, you can crab steer it to the right. So it's a pretty versatile tractor. Now the other thing you can do is change the direction. Cab lifts up, rotates around, and now you don't have to worry about backing this damn thing into anything, because with the cab rotated, forwards is forwards, backwards is backwards. And if I flip the cab around again, ready, and rotato on the cab. Forwards are still forwards, and backwards are still backwards. So that's why I love the Class Arion 5000. The cab rotation is awesome. And I just love this tractor to absolute bits. Now, no, I don't have the Platinum version, just letting you guys know. Haven't got that yet. Oh, and you can see, with the all-wheel steering, it's a little touchy. So I'm going to put it back into front steering mode, and that brings our stability up a lot. So when I'm maneuvering it, I can change it to all wheel and then just absolutely turn on the spot. So let's lower the pickup, turn on the foraging wagon, and go and pick up all this grass and get it fed to the cows. And what we don't feed to the cows, we can put into the silage bunker and kickstart it. So far, we've spent about $1.5 million on this farm. I told you $10 million wasn't much. This is what I also like about the Class Aerion. It's got a lovely little emblem right in the middle of the hood or the bonnet, whatever you want to call it. So you can line up your windrowed lines very straight. Okay, so let's turn off the forage wagon. We'll lift the pickup. And let's go and take it over the cows. Oh, that was a massive jump. Righto, cows. Let's drive forward a bit. And let's give you guys some grass. Now, I don't want to give them too much, because if you give your animals too much, you can't fit other foods in there. So, we've got water, 15,000. Oh, I want to get that up into at least the green. So, we'll feed them a little bit more. Let's check our animal screen again. A bit more. Wow, they're going to take all that grass. None left for our silage. Oh well. This means we have to get more. But that's okay. Anyway, guys and girls, I'm going to wrap today's episode up right there. Thank you so much for joining me. As I said, this is not really going to be a realistic farming series. If I do start running a bit low on cash, I will give myself a cash injection. But what you can be guaranteed of is there will be plenty of farming action. If I'm not doing one thing, I'll be doing another. And if I'm not doing that, I'll be doing something else. So, yeah, if you want to follow me on this series, don't forget, click the little alarm button to let you know that I've uploaded another episode. And post down the comment section below, what do you guys use on your farms? Like, what is your favorite farm equipment to use on your farm? Change to that so we can unload this and put the wheat into our storage. But yeah, post down in the comment section below, what farm equipment do you guys use? Do you use hook lifts like me? Or do you use dedicated tractors or trucks for jobs? And yeah, post your favorite brands down below. You guys already know my favorite tractor is the Class Zerion 5000. That's my fave. I like class equipment in general. So if someone said to me, you know, if you were going to make a farm, what things would you use? It'd be all class. So that's something you will see on this farm, is most of the equipment where I can help it will be class. If not, it'll be crone. But yeah, post down in the comment section below what you guys use on your farms. Until the next episode, I will say bye for now.